Hi, my name is Colonel Dr. Nawaz Sharif. I am the Chief Veterinarian at People for Animals Wildlife Hospital, Rescue and Conservation Center at Bangalore. So today I'll be talking to you about urban wildlife protection and development as a citizen movement for the sustainability of a city. So what do you understand by urban wildlife? So the term urban wildlife is used to denote animals of non-domesticated species living in and around a city. So these are birds, mammals, reptiles, and amphibians found in every neighborhood, residential complex, park, lakes, roads, gardens, on trees, in office buildings, and in forest fringes of a city. In a broader sense, they also include insects such as bees and butterflies. All these animals have a role to play in our ecological balance and health of a city. Without them, a city would become inhabitable in a short span of time. So we at the rescue center, what do? So we follow the 4 R's of rescue, recovery, rehabilitation, and release of the urban wildlife of Bangalore. So we have a robust rescue team of 5 rescuers, 5 ambulances, and 4 helplines working round the clock. So far we have rescued 27,000 animals of 201 different species, which includes 40% of the birds, 36% of the reptiles, and 22% of the mammals. So our team of veterinarians, rehabilitators, and rescuers work 24/7 and 365 days. So what does this urban wildlife, how does this urban wildlife help the city? So they play a very important role in the pollination and dispersal. 26% of our total rescues are pollinator species. So this wildlife is responsible for 90% of the green cover in our cities or town. And these animals pollinate 75% of our food crops. So they play a very important role. And their role in the disease control in the city. 65% of our total rescues are the pests of the disease controlling species. So they help in controlling diseases of zoonotic importance, which are transmissible from animals to human beings, like dengue, malaria, cholera, typhoid, plaque, and leptospirosis. You'd be surprised, the barn owl eats around 300 rodents in a year, the same number as the snakes. And the black kites, the Brahmini kites, the jungle crows, they help in clearing the organic waste. So they help in the garbage removal from the city. So the insects and the birds, the numerous species, they help in pollination, fruit, and the seed dispersal, which helps in grow trees, crops, parks, lakes in the neighborhood, which again gives home to wildlife, and which in turn help in the city's air quality, temperature control, soil fertility, and the food and the health. So the urban wildlife and the health of the city is interlinked. So one of the best places to save the wildlife in the cities, buildings, fields, lakes, parks, roads, and trees. So you should help them thrive, protect the habitats, let the animals be, and tell people. How we live decides how we preserve the city's urban wildlife. So make a choice for the city and the planet. The connection between the basic civic duties and wildlife preservation is strong. So we can do simple things which can help the thrive the wildlife in the city. Segregate garbage, dispose of waste responsibly, compost wet and organic waste at home in the office, prevent the burning of dry leaves and waste, grow more indigenous plants so that the birds can return. Avoid commercial insect fumigation in the gardens, which kills the pollinators and the wildlife and poison the soil. Put out pails of water during summer for neighborhood wildlife and for the other animals. Cut down on metals, foils, plastics. Carry a cloth bag, water bottle, and food boxes to work. Conserve water, electricity in your daily routine. Harvest rainwater and preserve our groundwater. Prevent cutting of trees. Cut down on packaging. Reduce food and e-commerce deliveries. Use eco-friendly detergents and soap, and leave no physical trace of your visit to a park, lake, field, river or forest, and walk, cycle or carpool. So all this will really help in the conservation. A city is as good as its people. Thank you.